Hello students, today I'm going to discuss regarding the t-test. Already we have learned that what a t-test is from the PPT. Let me give you a brief overview of what t-test is. That till now we have learned that a t-test is to be used whenever we are looking for the sampling of the samples when the sample size is less than 30, and whenever they are more than 30 we are looking for the z-test. T-test we have done for the one sample mean and for the difference of the two mean. The last lecture that I have added as a PPT is regarding the t-test when the samples are paired. What is the meaning of paired is? Paired means they are related to each other. They are related either in terms of that some experiment has been done and we are looking for the results of an experiment. Today, if we talk about that we all are at our home because of the COVID-19, and we still the government, the researchers, the scientists are working on making out a vaccination or some vaccine or the drug for the treatment of the COVID-19. So what we are going to do, they are going to test it, that what is the condition of a patient or the set of patients before medication and after medication, what are the improvements. Correct. So whenever we are looking for the improvement type of thing or the benefit of some technique, and we are looking for the results before and after, or we are looking for the results on a thing which are actually concerned to each other. Suppose an example that I have taken, if you see here, we have the data regarding the right ear and the left ear. Now both are the ears, and in a human being we are just going to find out that their performance is near about same or different. So we have taken the data, and whenever we are working on the t-test, you can open your PPT and see what the hypothesis over there is. We are looking for the hypothesis. Hypothesis is saying let me write down if I can. For H0, if we say the assumption we are taking for the null hypothesis is that there is no difference between the population mean for one and the another one, or we can say that the difference of the mean is zero. So here we are going to represent, instead of mu1 and mu2 jo humne liya tha last mein, let us take that here we will define H0 given by mu, the difference is equal to zero. Mu d is equal to 0. Now mu d is the same thing, the difference of mu1 and mu2, and the h1 that we have to take is that mu d is not equal to 0. So I think you can understand which type of test it is. One tailed or two tailed? Correct. It is a two tailed test. I assumed so that you have given the correct answer, but you have to be very clear about the tailed test, either it is one tailed test or a two tailed test. Correct. After that, the scenario comes that here what we are going to do, we have a data after and before of something. So what is the importance and why we are doing? So the first thing that we have is the sample will remain same. If you are talking about two sample before and after, then the sample value is same. So here the L will remain same. If you are talking about the sample size, so sample size is same in both of the data values that we have prior and after. It means we have taken a sample, we are testing something here, we have noted down the result, and we are testing something after the experiment and we have noted down the result. Now we want to compare the two results. So this is one of the thing. The formula that we have discussed is we have to calculate the value of t, and t is given by t is equal to we have d bar. D bar means the mean of the difference divided by the standard deviation SD divided by under root of n. So this is the formula that we are going to learn. We are going to calculate the mod of d from the calculated value. We have to take the absolute one, and finally to make out the decision we have to compare the mod t value with the standard value that will be given. If I talk about degree of freedom, which is very important regarding the t-test, so the degree of freedom here will be n minus 1, which is the sample size n. So this is the degree of freedom. Now if we have to find out the result, what we have to do, we have to find out the difference d. So the first thing we have to do is find out the difference d, and find out its mean we need d bar. So if I have to write down the difference, let me pause and write it down. So here we have noted down the differences. I have shown you that these are the differences d given by the difference of this. So what we have to do, we have to put a cursor, we have to go for is equal to, and here you have to do the same thing, is equal to this one cell value minus the another cell value, and press enter. So this is how we are getting the difference. The next step is we have to find out d bar. So how to find out the mean of d or d bar? We have to write down is equal to average, AVERAGE, correct, and in bracket we have to give the cell address because I know कि इसमें possible नहीं है, so we are going to take D2 to D11, bracket close and press enter. There is some error, let me check. So we are calculating the next step, which is the average of the values we have written. So I have written the formula is equal to average C2 to C11, and if I press enter over here, we are getting the value of 0.8. So this is what is the first step in calculating the T for the difference, for the pair T test. So this is our D bar, mean of D. So we have calculated this column D, and here I have calculated the average that you can see on the top. The next step is we have to find out the standard deviation of D also. So we have to write on is equal to STDEV. STDEV in bracket we have to give the again the column address where the values are given. So it is from C2 to C11, correct, press enter, and this is given me 2.93. So this is the value that we have calculated for the SD, and till now we have calculated D bar, and we know that the how many sample values we have, that is 10. So till now we have calculated, here you can see D bar, this is where SD and this is N. So how to calculate T? For T we have to write on the formula is equal to D bar, this is our D bar, divided by SD by under root N. So SD means the value that we have taken in the next cell. So either I can go there or I can write by myself D3, that is, this is D2 that we have written, this is D3, and it's important here to put a bracket because it is SD by SD under root N. So this SD into under root N, so SQRT, and N, and we know that the value is 10. Let me close this bracket and press enter. So the value is coming as 0.086. So this is the value we are getting for the calculation of T. So this is my T test for the paired samples. Now how the next step is? The next step is simply we have to compare the calculated value with the standard value which is given to you in the PPT, which is 2.262. So we can see that the value is less than the standard value. It means the decision is to accept the null hypothesis. It means there is no significant difference. This is the way how we can write on the decision, that there is no significant difference in the hypothesis, that the mean of the 1 year and the 2 year is same. Okay, there is no significant difference, means they are same. One more example that I am giving you and showing you to discuss is that after and before treatment, results of a drug is assigned to lower systolic blood pressure when subjects are treated with this their BP was taken before and after the drug, and these are the values. So today I am not posting it. This is a question given to you. You have to see that subjects are given. Here we have A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. These samples are given. And what we have before and after drug, the values are given of the blood pressure. So what you have to do here, I have written already to show you that in one of the column we can write on after or before. So let me name it as X and another as Y. So if we have, this is X and Y, we have the values of X, we have the values of Y, we have noted down. What is the next step? The next step is saying we have to calculate D. After calculating D, again we know the formula, D is saying we have to calculate is equal to this value 6.6, which is falling in C12, minus of this. If I press enter, I will get 0.2. similarly, if I proceed, what I will get is we will get the column of D. So you have to do it by yourself, create a column of D, find out the mean of all these D values, find out the standard deviation, and finally you have to find out the T value, which will be the for the paired T test. And in this example, if we browse through, this is the whole example. The standard value of T is given as 1.74. So what you have to do, we have to compare the obtained T value with this value. And if I got the value which is less than this standard value, the hypothesis will be accepted, otherwise rejected. So in order to start with an example, what you have to do, you have to start with the null hypothesis. Null hypothesis means the main value before and after is same, and the alternative is they are different. So in order to prove it, they are same or different, we have to calculate the difference. You have to calculate this d value, the whole column you have to frame. You have to find out the mean of d, as we have done earlier. You have to find out the standard deviation, and finally, using the formula of t, you have to go for the calculation. Okay, so this is all about the t test. Today I have uploaded PPT for the chi-square test, for which the video I will upload soon, and I will try to do all these on my desktop also, because till now I am using the mobile Android app. Just to show you that if you do not have the laptops with you, still it is possible for you to practice. Thank you. Stay healthy, stay safe.